Democrats owned the seat from the mid-70s through the mid-90s, but for the past 20 years, it has been a Republican stronghold.
One Democrat after another has challenged Virginia Foxx for the 5th District seat. None of them has ever won more than 43% of the vote.
I take every race seriously.
The North Carolina Republican has raised over $2 million for her campaign. Her challenger has raised a little more than $5,000. Foxx is a tireless critic of the president.
It's clear to me that his economic policies have completely failed.
She says during President Obama's time in office, the median family income has declined and unemployment remains too high. The latest numbers show the jobless rate fell below 6%, the lowest level in several years. The median income has been flat since falling in 2007.
Are we really that much worse off today than back in 2008?
Well, I don't remember the exact year, but we have fewer people work. We have no more people working now than I believe were working in 1974.
That's not accurate. Actually, there were 78 million people working back in 1974. Today, despite the bad economy, more than 139 million people have jobs in America. Overall, Foxx is not optimistic about the economy under President Obama.
So, you know, Bill, if we put a glass on this table, an 8-ounce glass, and it had 4 ounces of water in it, some people could say it's half full, some people would say it's half empty. So I think I say it's half empty in terms of the president's policies.
There have been no candidate forums or debates involving the two candidates in this race.
Have you had a chance yet to meet your opponent in this race?
I have not.
Do you know anything about where he stands, what he has to offer the voters of your district?
I have no ideas. As far as I know, he has no platform.
We don't know if the Democratic challenger in the 5th District has a platform or not. A brief conversation with his father is as close as we got to the candidate.
Yeah, he's in shorts and a t-shirt. He was on the phone in the middle of something.
We tried to interview the Democrat in this race, Josh Brannon, but never got the chance. After failing to reach the candidate by Twitter, Facebook, and email, we visited his home just outside of Boone. His father met us and told us that his son was home, but Josh Brannon never came out of the house.
We'll leave and go about our way.
I understand. Thank you, sir.
Watauga County Democrats tell us that Brannon is a serious candidate, very active on the campaign trail. Party leaders were just as surprised as we were that Brannon never responded to our request for an interview.
We visited Josh Brannon's house more than a month ago. We still have not heard back from the candidate. In Winston-Salem, Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.